Hello, my friends, and welcome to The Electric Viking. Thank you for subscribing to the channel. Hope you've had an awesome day, and thanks for your support, for liking the videos, and just for supporting the movement of, you know, what we're about, making the world a better place, and the world is becoming a better place every day, thanks to everything I talk about on this channel. Now, there is an onslaught of cars coming from China to Europe. And interestingly, there was an article last week in the state Chinese-owned newspaper gloating about NIO selling their cars in Norway and soon Germany and soon a number of other European countries as well. Gloating about it because the Chinese government wants their car companies to take over the world. Seriously, they want them to compete, to get market share. And I mean, let's be honest, every country wants their car companies to do that. It's not just the Chinese that want this to happen, but it is happening in a big way. It's going to happen very, very quickly because remember, the Chinese auto market is incredibly competitive, cutthroat, challenging. If you can compete and succeed in China, you can compete and succeed anywhere. There are more models, more makes, more EVs, more everything in China. Thus the reason I was quite surprised to see Tesla's Chinese sales numbers in September. I've got a video about that. I'll put it in the link in the description below and you can have a look at just what Tesla is up to in China. Now, really, let's be honest, this wave of new era Chinese cars should have some of the world's biggest car makers very, very worried. They know that the companies in China are building EVs at a far lower cost than what they are building them in Europe. For example, Volkswagen CEO admitted recently in a meeting between him and his directors that it takes Tesla only 10 hours to build the Model Y in China, whereas it takes Volkswagen 30 hours to build the comparable ID4 in Germany. That's three times as long. That's a lot more money. In addition to that, Volkswagen reportedly pay 30% more for their batteries than Tesla does. Now imagine that applying to Tesla and all the Chinese car companies. That's a scary thought. Now, makers such as MG, LDV, and Great Wall with Aura are lighting up the Australian new sales charts this year. And who would have thought? In Australia, people are very brand snobbish, very brand conscious, and yet they are buying Chinese electric cars and just Chinese vehicles in general at a crazy pace this year. MG sales are up 220% this year. It's now a top-selling brand in Australia. Lesser known LDV and Great Wall Motors are up 110% and 285% respectively. So how are they doing this? Well, they've won over buyers by offering affordable cars with long warranties and plenty of standard equipment. If you look at, here's a good example. If you look at the current Land Rover, top of the range, Range Rover, right? It comes with a 4-liter supercharged V8 with 440 kilowatts of power and 700 newton meters of torque. The carbon edition costs $300,000, right? So around about $200,000 US. And yet there is bigger media screens in Chinese cars that cost $7,000 US. Seriously, I'm talking multiple bigger media screens in those models, in the same car, in one car. The Chinese, in many ways, have gone well beyond some of their European counterparts. Now, most customers wouldn't know that Volvo and Polestar are actually owned by Chinese car-making giant Geely. Volvo still designs and develops its vehicles in Sweden, but really, most of them are built in China. And Volvo is at the forefront of electric vehicles, launching several models in Europe recently. The XC40 Recharge electric SUV was launched in Australia and worldwide, and will be joined by three other models in the near future. Now, Volvo's spin-off brand, Polestar, of course, also owned by Geely, Chinese parent company, is the brand's first electric vehicle and is expected to arrive in many global markets at the end of this year at a very competitive price. In fact, very competitive with the Tesla Model 3. In some markets, it's actually cheaper. Now, this vehicle called the Polestar 2 is built in China and it has a massive 11-inch touchscreen at the center of a vegan-friendly interior. Now, this touchscreen makes many of the touchscreens in other Chinese models look small. Some of them are up to 20 inches, some 30 inches. in comparable models. BYD is another maker looking to make its mark outside of China, and its sales of EVs in China have increased by 300% this year. In addition to that, very scary thought, they are actually the world's fourth largest battery manufacturer. In fact, they're so vertically integrated that they even make semiconductor chips for their cars. Now, BYD is set to launch in Australia in 2022 and even has an electric pickup truck, an electric ute, in the works. They're not just coming to Australia though, they're also going to Europe and the United States. Now, BYD plans to launch a range of cars that include at least two SUVs, a small car, and a sports sedan. The small car's already been launched in China. It's called the Dolphin. I'll put a link in the description below to that vehicle. Now, brands that are relatively unknown outside of mainland China are now launching in Europe. XPeng and NIO are electric vehicle brands aiming to carve out a name for themselves in emissions-focused Europe. Now, NIO is the most well-known and was only established in 2014. According to its share price, NIO is now worth US $58 billion, $80 billion in Australian dollars, which is more than Ford. Remember, Rivian, the electric startup company in the United States, actually started in 2011. And as of a month ago, it hadn't sold a single car. Well, have a look at how many vehicles NIO has sold. I'll put a link in the description below to a video I made about NIO's car sales doubling last month over the previous month before that. Now, in spite of the fact that NIO only sold 43,000 vehicles in 2020, they have more than doubled that figure this year. In fact, they sold nearly 11,000 in September alone. And that figure is expected to grow as NIO expands outside of China and into Europe, where petrol and diesel-powered cars will cease to be sold by 2030. NIO's first EV is the seven-seat ES8 SUV, which launched in select countries in Europe recently and has been met with very good reviews. It's a really good-looking vehicle, excellent value for the size of it, and it's similar to an Audi Q8. Now, NIO has an interesting solution to the recharging time that hamstrings electric cars, well, some of them anyway. The ES8's battery can be swapped at special stations being built across five cities in Norway and all across China, reducing the need for long recharging times. XPeng is another Chinese electric car startup that is poised for a big European expansion. XPeng has two vehicles, the P5 and the P7, which are of similar size to the Tesla Model 3 and the Tesla Model S, respectively. However, the P5 costs about $24,000. It costs a similar price to a Toyota Camry, yet comes with far more luxury, much, much bigger screens on the inside. It's better looking. The technology is way beyond that in a Toyota Camry, and it's an electric vehicle. It's actually the first vehicle in the world, consumer-level vehicle, that comes equipped with LiDAR that can be used for, well, autonomous driving. Now, in Europe, these vehicles are smartly styled, packed with equipment, have a generous driving range, and are very competitively priced compared to their luxury rivals. Obviously, much better priced, in fact. Then there are more EVs in the works with some seriously headline-grabbing features. The Byton M-Byte has a multitude of screens, including a huge 48-inch display running the entire length of the dash. This is about the same width as a 55-inch TV, to be viewed from just over an arm's length away. In addition to that, there is a 7-inch display located in the middle of the steering wheel. This display appears to control several infotainment functions such as music, maps, and aircon, among others. The emergence of Chinese electric car makers have some fearing that Japanese and American car makers will be left behind, because they most certainly will. Of course, outside of Tesla and Rivian, Ford and General Motors, and of course, Toyota are in huge trouble, with myself included and many others predicting that they may go bankrupt by 2030. I'll put videos in the description below showing my videos to you about the situation, why it is likely that companies like those and others, including Hyundai and Honda, are in serious difficulty and may not come out of this decade alive. Now, European and Korean makers are surging ahead in producing a wide range of exciting electric cars, but Japanese brands such as Toyota are lagging way behind and don't really have any plans to catch up. Remember, Toyota boss Akio Toyota recently told reporters that carbon is our enemy, not the internal combustion vehicle, taking a very different stance to European car manufacturers. He's in fact been opposing the EV taking over the ICE vehicle because he believes that it will decimate the Japanese car industry, as the Japanese car industry is incapable of pivoting to electric cars fast enough to compete with China. Now, Toyota says companies should use technologies already in use now, such as hybrids, to reduce emissions and focus on reducing emissions from other industries. In other words, he's trying to force people to buy a Toyota, not to let them choose the vehicle that they actually want to purchase. Now, US car makers are falling behind too. Ford is the most advanced with its Mustang Mach-E electric SUV on sale and the Ford F-150 Lightning due next year. However, Ford only sell about 8,000 Mach-Es per month. In comparison to Tesla's sales, BYD sales, NIO sales, XPeng sales, all of which are more than what Ford sell currently in their electric car range. Thank you for watching the video. Make sure to subscribe and like, and I'll see you again on the next one. Have a good day. Bye-bye.